everyone, welcome back to my channel for the third episode on Hill Short series. Well, we shall learn English literature before Chaucer today with special reference to Cynewulf. Well, do not get confused about the pronunciation. It is pronounced as Cynewulf as well as Cynewulf, but predominantly it is Cynewulf. So, the Anglo-Saxon poetry of Cynewulf belongs to the 9th century AD. He was a wandering gleeman, in the sense an entertainer, especially a singer. So, he was drawn towards the vision of the cross, and he was actually a lover of pleasure. And his themes were based on religion, especially Christianity. So, Cynewulf as a poet. He wrote beautiful verses rooted in Christian beliefs. He was the second Anglo-Saxon poet to write Old English Christian verses, and he was the author of many poems, and four of his significant poems are brought into reference here. So the poem Christ, so it deals with the treating of the incarnation of Christ, the descent into the hell, and also the ascension and the last judgment, right? So these are the themes based here. And now comes Ellen. So Ellen is a poetic account of Cynewulf, in which he takes an attempt of finding the true cross by Helena, the mother of Constantine. So now, Juliana. A Tale of Christian Martyrdom. It is a poem of 731 lines, and it is a retelling of a Latin prose life of Saint Juliana, a maiden. So here we could see that Juliana rejected the suit of a Roman prefect, Eleusis, because of her faith, and consequently she was made to suffer numerous torments, and Juliana is a documentation of all her sufferings. The Fates of the Apostles. So this is the shortest of Cynewulf's known canon, consisting of 122 lines. It was a brief martyrology of the 12 apostles of Christ. It deals with the key events that subsequently befell each apostle after the ascension of Jesus. And now comes The Dream of the Rood. So here, in this particular poem written by Cynewulf, the narrator gets a dream. In this dream or vision, he is speaking to the cross on which Jesus Christ was crucified. And it takes the label of the earliest dream poem. So though the authorship is attributed to Cynewulf, some say the poet is unknown, right? So this is all about today's episode. So stay tuned. More episodes are on the way. Do like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.